Shalom, shalom, Banyamian man. Back on it again. We another lesson, man. See? We always tell them, you know, we are Hills Negro. We are Hills Negro. We always reside to the hills, man. To the hillside, the bush. Right? And that's how we stand up strong. And that's how we do our thing. Yahawashi me and shy through the spirit. Kinda windy. But we have to work with the elements. With the Lord sent. Right? And here man, we're there up on the ground, man. I'll come to bring out the word of Yahawashi me and shy. Continue while it's kinda windy. But we have to work with the elements with the Lord sent. Right? Because yo, our people been doing all kind of folly and getting away with it. But all things done through the Heavenly Father, man. Because we, through the Heavenly Father, we have to keep on do what He ordained us to do, man. Right? Now what He ordained us to do, yo, we can't divide ourselves from it. We have to just keep doing it. And yo, amongst our people, we find some wicked people, man. Backbiters, haters. In a country where I grew up, where I born, my baby's string cut, called Ironman. Yo, nothing higher down there. Because I be a backbiter down there. People wouldn't really want to see each other strive in the right direction and have positive role model around them to build, bring up them children. Them rather see chaos, man. So that's why right now, the segment I want me to go in, it pertaining to the people of our nation where them collide and them, you know, include the other nation in them doings and plot with the other nation for the downfall of them brother, especially Amashiach Yahawashi. And that's why, yo, you have some people they call Maroon. You have different type of maroon. And you have maroon where make alliance with Bakra Master. And when they make alliance with Bakra Master, you're frightened, fear what they have done to them own people for 30 pieces of silver. Just like what Judas have done to Amashiach Yahawashi, sell him out for 30 pieces of silver. And without further ado, we glorify the Father ourselves. Brakta Yahawah, Brakta Yahawashi, Brakta Yahawah, Brakta Yahawashi, Emmanuel, Shalawah, Kom Yasharahla. Yeah man, we're there up on the ground, man, and we have to keep on bringing out this word of the Heavenly Father. But anywhere we're going on this world, right? Without further ado, we get the book of John. This is John chapter 6. Start at verse 64. John chapter 6, verse 64. Let it read. But there are some of you that believe not, for Yahawashi know from the beginning who they were that believe not, and who should betray him. So you see, Amashiach Yahawashi, who the world ignorantly called Jesus Christ, him know from the beginning who are going to believe him and who not going to believe him. Right? It's as simple as that. And it says, and he said, therefore, said I unto you, that no man can come unto me except it were given of unto him of my Father. So sometimes I wonder how me and my brethren them reach, where we reach, because we are come from all different background, back part of life, where some of us humanizer, some of us dealer, some of us so-called gangster, We're coming from different background, various background, right? Some of us treading the right road, have that concept in life, from mourning of righteousness, right? So basically, the Lord know who he might go choose to come and do his work. It has to give in from his Father. We can't just take up ourselves and just walk and come so we are going to do the work of the Heavenly Father. You have man who come and do them things, but them always do what happened to them. They have to be sieved out. Right? That's why you don't see them. Because the Heavenly Father sent out the sieve and him sieved them. And them have to take with themselves. Because there was the grain that never refined enough to come and do his work. They never have that mindset of willpower and strong mind. Right? Send us sieve out what we need and throw the rough grain. Right? Verse 66. For that, from that time, many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him. Then said Amashiach unto the 12, will you also go away? Then Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to who shall we go? Thou hast the words of eternal life. So you see, we understand, said the Heavenly Father, the words of eternal life. So who we are going to go to? When we come to eternal life, we have to stick around and stay with eternal life. Because Mashiach Yahawashi, he has the word of eternal life. Because this word give your spirit a different function in life. Give your mindset a different meds in life. You wise up, man. You take yourself away from pollution. You take away yourself away from the thinking of this way of life. We don't confound ourselves to this world. We move to the spiritual realms where the Lord says his word give you eternal life. Right? Can it read? Then said Yahawashi unto the 12, will you also go away? Then Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to who shall we go? Thou hast the word of eternal life, and we believe and are sure that thou art that Christ, the Son of the living God. Yahawashi answered them, have not I chose you 12, and one of you is a devil. So you see, the Lord knew that one of the 12 was a devil. As he chose the world, 12 of them, because they was come from the Father, right? But him said, yo, him knew one owner, the devil, man. And that's why, yo, when you have virgins, sisters around you, and basically everybody there on one accord, doing the work of the Heavenly Father, we only can pray that we stay in contact and we have the same mind. And we are looking for the same outcome, right? We're not looking for carry down, bring come. But you see, amongst the virgin, you always find a carry come, carry go, bring come. You always find a Judas. You always find one. We are going to try to overstep the mark and try to do things where it's not about. Supposed to really do, right? Because, yo, Amashiach Yahawashi chose 12 and Judas was one of the 12. But Judas had different things in mind. But let me read that. Let it read. He speak of Judas Iscariot to the son of Simon, for he it was that should betray him, being one of the 12. So you see, being one of the 12, he knew who's gonna betray him, man? But did he run him away? No. He never run him away. He endure with him. Because he came here, and he came here for a reason. And when we come into this world, we don't know our purpose in life until, yo, we find our way doing what you don't even set out in life, say. Not for us aspiration in life, say. Or somehow we want to be pilot, somehow we want to be soldier, some of you want to be police, all kind of different wheels in this way of life that we was, you know, taught from a little young age, brought, you know, by our parents. But we won't find ourselves that the righteousness. Not in the Christian church, because we was all in the Christian church knowing in our mindset from the get-go that there's a higher power and there's a God. Because we are God chosen people. So it run now with DNA, now with genes, it now whole body. Right? We know somebody there's a creator. So we being the chosen people of Yahawah, Shimei, and Shai, we always pray to God. And you know, we've been tricked, bamboozled, and tell lies. So we used to see this image where we never have the understanding that the Lord, so we shouldn't pray to no image, man. But we see this image and we think it was right and was like praying to it. Not praying to it, basically praying to the Heavenly Father. But seeing that image, you know, see, feel like somebody. Your mindset basically was after Christianity. What they have forced upon us and we have to eat it because what? Disobedient. We've been tossed aside. So being tossed aside, what's been taught to us, we are going to gravitate to it. But no, we are what? We are make sure, say, yo, we subdue that what was in our mind. And the Lord start to show us righteous path. The Lord start to refresh our brain, clear up the cobwebs, clear up the darkness that they set up amongst us. But a lot of our brothers and sisters still in it, them not clear up, because the Lord say new, and Father God send us to him. Not we just walk and see some brethren and deal with the righteous part, and we just walk onto it. We see the Christian church and we thought it was righteous, and we walk onto it. We in there and we find out that something is wrong. Because as they reach and you sit down on the bench, you just want to get up and come out of the place because your head starts hurting, your back hurts you. There's something going in there where it's not right. So your spirit wasn't feel comfortable in that sense. Right? You was forced to stay there for 2 hours and then program you with a thing called program. Right? Now this is Matthew chapter 27. I'm going to start at verse 3. And it read, then Judas, which had betrayed him, when he saw that he was condemned, repented himself and brought again the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and elders. So you see, when Judas find out him betrayed Amashiach Yahawashi, and him see the treatment where Amashiach Yahawashi go under, and him know that Amashiach Yahawashi was a good man, being around him, see him feed homeless, see him take care of sick, see him open the eyes of the blind, see him cure the lunatics, right? See him cure man of all forms of, you know, illness, see him cure men, cripple. So these are the things when him, the spirit there will come upon him of hatred, where him open him mouth and him, you know, sell him out. That spirit that came upon him of wants and need, which is just lust of the flesh, and him take on unto it and sell out him brother. Wendo. Verse 4, saying, I have sinned in that I have betrayed the innocent blood. And they said, what is that to us? See thou to that? So Judas say, yo, me betray a innocent blood. Me sin. Look what me have done. Him repented. But him repented can't work, man. Him repented. Him should have been, as the scripture that say, man, it better if him never born, man. And one milk stone did hang around him neck and cast to the bottom of the sea. Right? And it says, verse 5. And he cast down the piece of silver in the temple and depart and went and hang himself. Just like what me da say when me just said I start this video, man. The maroon them collide with Bakra Master and they were selling back the runaway slave. that run away from Bakra Master, the oppressor, for 30 pieces of silver. That's what they was collecting from the British. When the runaway slave see them and check the boy, them run to them brother. Them run to a militia group, call themselves Maroon, we collide with the oppressor, bring them back unto them. 30 pieces of silver. So that ring supposed to ring a bell in our head. I know that these oppressors was mocking the Maroons, knowing that these men selling back them brother, just like what them do to Amashiach Yahawashi, would were ignorant they call Jesus Christ, man. But did they have the understanding what they were doing? I know they was mock. I know them take them for a ride. Because what? No phone love likes. Yo, we are endure, man. And we are endure. If we lose this life, man, the Lord say we're gonna find it. So we not wall up on the way. I feel like we don't want to tread upon the fence and sit down and want to be sleep ourselves. We have put yourself on the line. Verse 6. And the chief priest took this silver piece and said, it is not lawful for to put them into the treasury, because it is the price of blood. So you see, Judas threw down the 30 piece of silver, man, and go hang himself, man, because the thing what he have done, him couldn't live with himself. He knew that he have done things where him can't live with himself no more. He know that him do something where it's horribly wrong, man. Right? Let me get John chapter 18. This is the book of John chapter 18. I'm going to start at verse 33. Then Pilate entered into the judgment hall again and called Amashiach Yahawashi and said unto him, art thou the king of the Jews? Yahawashi answered him, say thou this thing of Slakia. Yahawashi answered him, say thou this thing of thyself, or did others tell it thee of me? Same as you say it yourself, or did others tell you, say me are the king of the Jew? Of course, Amashiach Yahawashi, the king of the Jew, he was our king. Right? And it read. Pilate answer, I am a Jew. So like, yeah, Pilate answer, am I a Jew? So in other words, he must say to Amashiach Yahawashi, well, am I a Jew? Which he's not a Jew. He's a dog, man. Right? And it read, verse, 35. Then thy whole nation and the chief priests have delivered thee unto me. So he must say, yo, me not, am I a Jew? Your own nation and the chief priests deliver you unto me, you being a Jew. So this is the thing what me I tell you about, the sellout amongst our people, the backbiting amongst our people. We're supposed to look upon each other and bear each other burden. But you see, the way our people been so caught up in wants and greed and licky long tongue people, not like keep them tongue in their head and hold them on and tough out them needs at time. No, them like sell and buy. Them sell the innocent man blood, right? And enough of them, when them do these things, hear enough of them talk about the blood of the Lord is upon me. The blood of the Lord, the blood of the Lord. When me hear say certain things, man, me know that uno are the people ready and willing to do the selling, man. Right? Because yo, we have to have compassion on each other, man. We can't degrade each other, man, and bring down each other. And that go on because what? We've been taught by the oppressor, and the oppressor not teach us nothing but hatred. We learn everything from him, because yo, everything what we learn basically him pump it more in a way. Because yo, if he might teach us righteousness, he not gonna teach us righteousness, which is righteousness of the scripture, where we should walk. Right? He might teach us things where basically suit for needs. He might gonna tell us if you love him and hate your own. Look up to him. Cause he might give you something where you feel like say, yo, something where he might give unto you. He's so nice, he's so kind. Look how thoughtful he is, right? But these are the things that them do for blind on the eye. Because yo, me always say this, man. Me a heal Negro, man. Right? When me say me a heal Negro, me a heal Negro. Because basically, me is a man, me no love likes. Me is a man, me go look my own from me a little youth. Me a little youth, man. Yo, me in a mango tree, me go pick mango. Me go sell mango, man. Right? Me a little youth, me go pick Guinness, me go sell Guinness, man. Me a little youth, me hustle, man. Me do things when me know say, boy, yo, me can help myself. Me not sit down and wait for people to give me things, cause them things that are gonna make your mind get, you know, lazy. You not gonna give your mind that training attitude to go and do things so you can make things happen for yourself. You are gonna keep on sitting down and wait for somebody to put something on your table to eat. Lord, so we not for be to come around and come be no beggars. Enough for you to come around and have that attitude. Sit down and wait for people for doing the things. And that's how we not sell each other. Because Pilate said, he might not Jew, but you're not bringing up man, you're not bringing up king, come sell me. The chief priest was supposed to stand up stiff, bold, on the ground and defend them, brother. Right? Verse 36. Yahawashi answered, my kingdom is not of this world. So that's why they have to sell him. Because I'm a Shia Kiyawashi, I say, yo, Pilate, what do you feel like? If this was my kingdom, you check, say, the high priest could have come sell me. No, it could not be. He must say, my kingdom is not of this world. And that's why our mind set, our body, our aim, the strength where the Lord put in us, it's not of this world. It's of the kingdom to come. But we have to lay the foundation. That's what we are doing right now. Through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shimei and Shai. Lord willing. Right? And it read. Verse 36. Yahusha answered, my kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, then would my servant fight that I should not be delivered to the Jew? But no is my kingdom not from thence. So him say, yo, if this was my kingdom, my servant the fight, man, the one that deliver me over unto the evil thought of the people them which are around each other. Nah, that would not happen. Because this would happen, man. Let me get Luke, man. Lock it. We get Luke chapter 19 verse 17. This would happen, man, if it was a Mashiach Yahawashi kingdom at the time. Because yo, no phone attack all kind of folly, man. This is what a Mashiach could have done if it was his kingdom. This is Luke 19 verse 27. But those my enemy, which would not that I should reign over them, bring hither and slay them before me. So the high priest there, and Judas and the whole of them inchman were sell him out. Guess what the Lord said? Them would have pop off them head fly, man, hand gone, disfigured. Members spread all over the place, man. That's the power we serve Yahawah Shimei and Shai. So then a guy now go come and go and like say my backbite. And he might turn up his mouth and he might turn down his mouth and he might disrespect. Because the Lord know the whole of our heart. The Lord know all in our mind before we even whooping them out. Right? So that's why, yo, brothers and sisters, we are serve a power which is Yahawah by Shimei or Shai. So yo, the humbler I will be, and the better it is for women. Right? Let me get the book, John chapter 9, I'm gonna start at 19 verse 11. Yahawashi answered, "Thou could have no power at all against me, except it was given thee from above." So you see, the Lord is the one that do all things. Yahawah is the Father. Yahawashi is the Son. And we, the servant, underneath Amashiach Yahawashi. So all power be given from Yahawah. So when Amashiach Yahawashi come here to be sold out unto these criminals, Pilate, and friend them, and of our people, the corrupted backbiters, the Jews that deliver our brother unto these wicked men, that it was ordained from Yahawah for these things to happen. So that's why Amashiach Yahawashi say, yo, you know the power, man, the power that you have me right now under, it was given from above, man, from Yahawah. Because he was come here as a sacrificial lamb at that time to die for the nation, man. Right? And him to die for everyone. Because basically you can see the wicked Jews amongst us deliver him over unto the chief priest, and the chief priest deliver him over unto Pilate. So who was the chief priest? There was the, amongst us, our nation as well. Right? So that's why the backbiting and these things, it a go on from ancient days. It not just start. A something where I go on. You understand? So we have to overstand the whole situation that, yo, amongst us, as the Lord saying in Jeremiah chapter 5 verse 26, you find wicked man. You understand? So wicked man reign our nation, and them feel like them have a point to play, part to play. Yes, them have a part to play. But yo, it is better a millstone should have hung round their neck, man, and then throw in a sea to have a come upon them. Right? Judgment I got take them, man. Right? St. John chapter 19 verse 11. Yahawashi answered, "Thou couldn't have no power at all against me, except it were given thee from above. Therefore, he that deliver me unto thee had the greater sin." You see that? Verse 12. Slakia. Verse 12. And from thenceforth Pilate thought to release him. But the Jews cried out, saying, "If thou let this man go, thou art not Caesar, friend." Friend. Whosoever make himself a king speak against Caesar. So you see, these are the wickedness amongst our people, man. So the man say, yo, if you let him go, you know, you're not Caesar, you know. So yo, basically the man show him, say, yo, you have to get rid of this man. Verse 13. When Pilate therefore heard that saying, he brought Amashiach Yahawashi forth and sat down in the judgment seat in a place that is called the pavement, but in the Hebrew, Gabata. Right? So in the Hebrew, it's the pavement are called Gabata in the Hebrew. So basically, the Jews that the Lord was sent unto, them tell Pilate, say, yo, now let the man go, man. Right? For them have compassion upon the brother. No, say, yo, this brother do all things for a nation. Him heal the sick. Him heal the blind. What him not do, man? Right? Let me get Matthew. Matthew chapter 27. Matthew chapter 27, I'm going to start at 20. But the chief priests and the elder persuaded the multitude that they should ask Barabbas and destroy Amashiach Yahawashi. The governor answered and said unto them, whether of the twin will you that I release unto you? They said, Barabbas. Same as the governor say, yo. Governor say, what happened? Who do want me release? Who do want me release Amashiach Yahawashi? And you want me release Barabbas? What the people them say? How can we make up this thing, man? They said, Barabbas. Pilate said unto them, what shall I do then with a Mashiach, which is called Christ? Slakia. Pilate said unto them, what shall I do then with Yahawashi, which is called a Mashiach? They all say, you know, Christ just mean a Mashiach, right? And Jesus, that is Yahawashi, because we call him by his Hebrew name, right? And Christ mean a Mashiach. So like, yeah. They all said unto him, let him be crucified. Now this was the wish of our nation. Let him be crucified. And the governor said, why? What evil had he done? But they cry out the more, saying, let him be crucified. Right? So this is what they wish for the man of the Lord, where he stand upon the road, bringing out the word of the Heavenly Father. They all want to see the back of us, because Christ hasn't done nothing wrong. More than all what Christ was going about doing, healing the sick, right, making the blind see, doing things that people have never seen before, right? Doing things where it was only a good thing for a man don't have to see the physician, and a man does see him and does talk, and for you have that belief, you've been cured of whatever sickness come upon you. This woman, she have issue with blood for how much years, man? And then she have that faith to go and see a Mashiach Yahawashi and touch him, infringe the hem, touch him fringe. And when she touch him fringe, she was made whole from that very same moment, man. Right? So these are the things that the man was, Yahawashi Yahawashi was going around doing, looking after his nation and his own nation, the high priest and all these men didn't want to see him keep on doing what he was doing, because they're worried about what people are going to look up to them, like how they used to look up to them before. Because our nation, them love likes, and them sister Mashiach Yahawashi are going to get all of the likes, all of the happenings. People are going to start look to him. And before, they could have sit back and said, yes, this is the man that Amashi, that come from Yahawah, was sent to heal the nation. They plan up with the enemy to take him out, right? So we have said everything is from ancient days, still happen right up until today. It just happened in a different way, right? We see people come against people in all different form. Telephone call, man send man for man, and then when they look, man meet them demise, right? These are the things, man. Verse 24, then Pilate saw that he could prevail nothing, but that rather a tumult was made, he took water and washed his hand before the multitude, saying, I am innocent of the blood of this just person. See he to hit. Say, so I'm innocent of this just man. Wanna see that? See he to it. Wanna deal with it? Right? Verse 25. Then answer all the people and said, his blood be upon us and on our children. And that's why you see Christian church, where them love that word. The blood of Jesus is upon you. The blood of them who see him once said, the blood of Amashiach Yahawashi be upon them and be upon them children. Right? So when him come here, man, Him come here for die, for the sacrificial law. Where we used to be wicked, and then boom, we go kill, make atonement, we go kill one animal, and say, boy, yo, this is for the sin, where them just committed. And that's why Christ said after coming to the world, man, because Israel was getting wicked and wicked and wicked, man. And right today, not no change. Them get even worse. That's why the Lord said, man, it's a remnant in comfort. So Lord willing, we don't know. We only hope we are part of the remnant. Because the Spirit of the Lord put upon us to continue doing the will. Who can separate us from Yahawashi, Yahawashi? It's only Yahawah can separate us from Yahawashi, Yahawashi. So we just keep on motivate one another and keep on motivate brothers and sisters, four corners of the earth. And yo, we feed off each other, man. We sit and we watch each other video, man, and we see each other bring out, you know, and then boom, that maybe put some spirit in you for God, do a video, whatever way you want to do it. That's how we feed off each other, because we're one mind, one spirit, one body. In a Mashiach Yahawashi, man. Right? Verse 25. So, like, yeah. Then answer all the people and said, his blood be upon us and our children. Then release he Barabbas unto them. And when he had scourged Amashiach, Slakia, Yahawashi, he delivered him to be crucified. Then the soldier of the governor took Amashiach into the common hall and gathered unto him the whole band of soldiers, and they stirred him and put on him a scarlet robe. And when they had planted a crown of thorn, they put it upon his head and a reed in his right hand, and they bowed his knee before him and mocked him, saying, hail the King of the Jews. And they spat upon him and took the reed and smite him on his head. So you see, then spat at him, man, spit at him, disrespect him, smite him, do him all kind of things, the bands of soldier, man, right? For what? What was his crime? They haven't done any crime. What is our crime? Teaching the word of God. We haven't done any crime. But because of the hatred and the wickedness of the mindset of all manner of men, both heathens, Jews, the wickedness that they keep doing, then I want, you know, see ear righteous, boom, righteous vibration around them. Because what? They knew that they pollute themselves in all kind of matter where them shouldn't pollute themselves, you know. So they want to carry on in there, so they are gonna justify what they're doing. So them don't want to hear nothing truthful, nothing righteous. That is so dagger in them heart. That is something we're boxing them, pushing them aside. So them don't want to hear that. They want to hear things we're gonna keep on them, motivate themselves in all kind of folly. Because these big grown-ass people, they are small children. They might look overgrown and look like big man, big beard up, big woman, have on them, you know, well flowers up, well looking like a big grown adult woman, but their mind is still as a child. Because what they're looking for, they're looking for entertainment. What a child look for? A child look for entertainment. A child look for, you know, fun. Oh, mommy, daddy, can you take me to where we can have some fun? We can ride on a roller coaster. We can go and party. And we can have fun. That's what children look for, right? And these grown adults, what they're looking for? Entertainment. They want to go to party. They want to go to dance. They're looking for entertainment, so they are growing as children. Big children walking around, stupid as stupid can be, man. Right? Because the long nose boy, right? The Pinocchio nose boy, gas them up and take them away from righteousness. So this is all them know. Party, party, bull, you understand the rest. Right? Verse, let me reach. Yeah, that's it on that. Let me jump to verse 35. And they cry, and they crucify him, and parted his garment, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet. They part my garment among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lot. Just like what it says in Psalms chapter 22, verse 16, man. David already prophesied about Amashiach Yahushai. Isaiah did the same thing, right? Verse 36. And sitting down, they watch him there, and sat upon. Slack here. Verse 37. And set up over his head his accusation written, This is Yahawashi, the king of the Jews. You see that? Amashiach Yahawashi. Yahawashi, Amashiach Yahawashi, man. He's the king of the Jews, and he's our king. Kings of kings, lords of lords. Conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, man. He's a Judahite, man. Right? Let me get Mark. This is the book of Mark, chapter 15, and I start at verse 26, and it reads, and the superscription of his accusation were written over the king of the Jews, and with him they crucified two thieves, the one on his right hand and the other on his left. And the scripture was fulfilled which says, and he was numbered with the transgressor, and they that passed by rail on him, wagging their head and saying, ha, thou hast destroyed the temple and build it in 3 days. So you see, Amashiach Yahawashi, them disrespect him so much, man. And say, yo, you destroy the temple and build it in 3 days. Because, yo, when Christ died, he was gonna rise on the third day. So, yo, these things was fulfilled, man. All what we are reading about right here. Because these things was already talk of the prophet. And these things was fulfilled when Christ come. Right? Save thyself and come down from the cross. Likewise also the chief priest Mark said among themselves with the scribe, he saved others himself he cannot save. You see, him save others, but him cannot save himself. He come here and he do all miracle that no man ever walked this face of this earth have done. And you see the disrespect what they have given him. Him save others, but him can't save himself. He never come to save himself. Him come to do what? Pay the penalty. Right? Him come to take away the sacrificial law from us being wicked amongst our one another. When we do evil, we go kill lamb. And say, boy, we are the sin where we have commit, we atone. You understand? We eradicate the sin. So he must come and he must die for that law to eradicate. And no phone walk and talk about him blood upon him. Wait. Verse 31. Likewise also the chief priest mocking among themselves with the scribe. He save others, himself he cannot save. Let Christ, the King of Israel, descend now from the cross, that he may see and believe that they that are crucified with him reveal him. And when the sixth hour was come, there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour, right? And at the ninth hour, Yahawashi cried with a loud voice, saying, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, which is being interpreted, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? And some of them that stood by, when they heard it, said, behold, he called Elijah, Elijah. And one ran and fell at a sponge full of vinegar and put it on a reed and give him to drink, saying, let alone, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down. And Amashiach, Yahawashi, cried with a loud voice and gave up the ghost, man. So right there's a man, them mocking, them taunting, them disrespecting, man. Well, Amashiach, Yahawashi, hold him judgment, will come upon him. Can him endure as a good soldier for Yahawah, man. Right? It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of Yahawah, Shimei and Shai, man. A fearful thing to fall into the hands of Yahawah, man. Right? But them taunt to brother, them mock him, them disrespect him. Them do everything what them can do to him, to grieve him spirit. But him hold it and him ball out. My God, my God, my God. You forsake me, right? Yo, read these things, man. Yo, yeah, if you don't feel emotional, man, and feel a way, because, yo, the spirit that run through us, man, it's running a Amashiach Yahawashi, man. And yo, it's grieve our spirit, man, knowing these things that we have been done unto Yahawah Shimei and Shai. Right? Let me get the book of John, chapter 20. It is John chapter 20. And I start at verse 27. I read. Then said he to Thomas, reach hither thy finger, and behold my hand, and reach hither thy hand, and thrust it into my side, and be not faithless, but believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him, my Lord and my God. Yahawashi said unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed it. Blessed are they that have not seen and yet have believed. So you see, it is good when a brethren are assisted, not see certain things, but then believe, man. The Lord said, blessed are they. Right? Blessed are they that have not seen and yet have believed. So sometimes you don't see things, man, but you believe what is written, because it was written for your learning, right? Verse 30, and many other signs truly did Amashiach Yahawashi in the present and of his disciples, which are not written in this book. So you see things where the Lord have done, not written in the book, man. Some things left out. Because, yo, not everything was, you know, document what he have done. Some things left out. Verse 31, But these are written that you might believe that Yahawashi is the Christ, Amashiach, the Son of God, Yahawah. And that believing ye might have life through his name. So you see, we are gonna have life through his name, man. His name is important. And Jesus is not his name, man. Jesus is a slave ship that took us away on a voyage, man. Right? So we have to call upon a Yahawashi, a Mashiach, Christ. You understand? So that's how we think, man. And we are gonna keep on moving in the righteous spirit of a Mashiach Yahawashi, man. Right? Let me get the book of Acts. This is Acts chapter 1 verse 4. And being assembly together with them, command them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which said, he have heard of me. So Mashiach can tell the disciple them, say, yo, when you don't leave Jerusalem, wait for the promise. Because this time him already die and rise. So he must say, yo, wait for the promise from the Father of me. Right? Verse 5. For John truly baptized with water, but he shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost. Not many days went. Same as John baptized with water. But yo, water baptism, no say nothing no more. Because we are going to baptize with the Holy Ghost. Right? So the Holy Ghost that come in with what? The Holy Ghost is the Holy Spirit, man. The Holy Spirit is the word of the Heavenly Father. That's why we say we have to make sure we search the scripture daily, because in this we find eternal life. So the scripture are going to change us. Because when you read it, it are going to resonate with your spirit. And you are going to visualize where you read. Right? Verse 6. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? So you see, the disciple asked Mashiach, Yahawashi. I say, you are going to restore the kingdom unto us, because even when Christ was in town, that's why he said, my kingdom is not of this world. My kingdom is not, if my kingdom was of this world, my servant would fight for me. Right? In other words, verse 7. And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the time or the season which the Father had put in his own power. So it's not, Christ says, not for you, us, to know the time or the season. We have to have faith in this thing, man. Because if enough of us know that a Lord will come tomorrow, enough of us are going to start doing look at thing and make sure we say, yo, we get ourselves together when we're wicked as hell, man, from over 20 years, 30 years coming up. But when the time comes, when them know the Father are going to come, them are going to put themselves together and act like the best thing. No, and I saw this thing, man. We have to have faith and we have to suffer. Because Christ come here and suffer for us, man. So what? We feel like we are just walking in the kingdom, squeaky clean. Yo, we have to go through trial and tribulation, man. We have to endure, man. Hardship as a good soldier. If you are Mashiach Yahawashi, man. Right? Verse 8. Ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and you shall be witness unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. So when it's the uttermost part of the earth, four corner of the earth, man. That's why you see the youth them, the man of the Lord them on the road right now. I bring out the words of the Heavenly Father. Right, the four corner of the earth. Verse 9. And when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. So the cloud represent the chariot, man. The chariot come up and took him up while he was amongst them. Right? And while they looked steadfast towards heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel. So two men come in white apparel, man. Now hear what them say. Which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Yahawashi, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as you have seen him go into heaven. So in other words, you must say, yo, the same way you see him take up and gone up to the cloud, man, that's the same way you're gonna see him come back unto us, man, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shimei and Shai, man. So we have to have faith in this thing, man, right? We have to have faith in this thing, children of Israel. We have to have faith, man. We have to hold on for eternal life of Mashiach Yahushai, right? Let me get the book of John. John chapter 14 and start at 26, and it read, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, which, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, who the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance. Whatsoever I have said unto you. So the Comforter is the Holy Spirit, man. It has got to teach us things, man. Right? And the Holy Spirit is not stamping your feet and talking tongues. That is madness. Rabababa. That is craziness, man. The Holy Spirit come from the scripture. Study to make yourself as proof, man. You have to keep reading and get understanding, and the Lord will open your understanding, open your mind, and build you up in this thing, man. Verse 27, it read, peace I have, peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you, not as the world give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. So that's why we can't be afraid in this thing, man. The Lord said, I'm left peace with us, man. So we have to have peace amongst brethren and sisters, man. Let not your heart be troubled, man. Right? You have heard how I said unto you, I go away and come again unto you. If you love me, you would have rejoiced, because I said, I go unto the Father, for my Father is greater than I. So you see, no phone at all, but Mashiach Yahawashi is the Father and image, the Son in a one. Listen, the Trinity is garbage, man, right? Verse 29, and now I have told you before it come to pass, that when it is come to pass, you might believe. Hereafter I will not talk much with you, for the prince of this world come and had nothing in me. You see that? When it said the prince of this world, this is talking about the darkness of this world. And when I say darkness, I'm not at nighttime. I talk the dark force of this place, the people them that are ruling, the enemy of Christ, the enemy of Mashiach, right? These are the prince of this world, right? Never touch that later on. Let me read it again. Hereafter I will not talk much with you. So right now, the Lord, not even righteousness in this place like how it should have been. That's what it has said. For the prince of this world come and had nothing in me. You necessarily be a party, bullshit, and all kind of fooling which take place round this place. Eh? Excuse my French. Right? Be a madness take place round this place. So there's no righteous, conscious people about in this place. More than people were sleeping, kicking stone, walking about their own folliness. Verse 31, but that the world may know that I love the Father, and as the Father gave me commandment, even so I do. Arise and let us go then. So the Lord gave us commandment, even Yahawah gave Amashiach Yahawashi commandment. So he gave us commandment. So then we have to keep on right now doing. Right? So this is it, man. Where the Father assures, man. Right? Let me get Matthew. This is Matthew chapter 19, verse 16, and it read, and behold, one come and said unto him, good master, what good things shall I do that I may have eternal life? And he said unto him, why call thou me good? There is none good but one, that is Yahawah. But if thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandment. This is out of Christ's mouth, red letter, man. So I tell a man, say, why you call me good for, man? Unglam, Yahawah is good. So if you want to enter into life, do the commandment, man. Right? So we have to keep the commandment, man. Straight up, man. There's no getting around it, man. Right? And let me get the book of John chapter 17. John chapter 17. I'm going to start at verse 20. And it read, neither. Like I'm start from 19. As for their sake, I sanctify myself, that they also might be sanctified through the truth. So this is the truth, man. Right? Neither pray I for these alone, but for them also which shall believe on me through their words. So through our words, we have brothers and sisters. We are going to wake up and take heed and come to the words of the Heavenly Father. That they, slack here. The Lord said, through us teaching, others are going to come unto his word. Right? So, neither pray I for these alone, but for them also which shall believe on me through their words. So, through we bring out the words of the Heavenly Father, them also are going to believe and come to the words. Right? Let me get Matthew chapter 28, I believe. Yeah, Matthew chapter 28, yeah, verse 19, and it says, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Ghost. So the Holy Ghost is through the words, man. Right? And it says, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have command you, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen. So you see, the Lord has tell us, the man of the Lord, say, yo, we have to go out there and preach his word and teach them. Four corner earth, man. Right? Because, yo, he gave us a strict job to do, man. And we have to keep on do it, man. Right, let me go back to John 17. John 17, and I start at 21. They all might be one, as thou, Father, art in me, and I in thee, that they also may be one in us, that the world may believe that thou hast sent me. And the glory which thou givest me, I have given them, that they might be one, even as we are one. So you see, Yahawah Shimmy and Shai, when you look upon Yahawah Shimmy and Shai, you look upon the Father, because the Son represents the Father, man. My Son represents me, right? Verse 23. I in them, and thou in me, that they may be made perfect in one, and that the world may know that thou hast sent me, and hast loved them as thou hast loved me. Father, I will that they also who thou hast given me be with me where I am, that they may be behold my glory which thou hast given me, for thou loved me before the foundation of the world. O righteous Father, the world has not known thee, but I have known thee, and thee have known that thou hast sent me. See? And I have declared unto them thy name, and will declare it, that the love wherewith thou hast loved me may be in them, and I in them. So that's why the Lord live in us, man. Right? That's why I read the book of Luke chapter 17, verse 21, man. He said, neither look over this or not over this. God, the Lord is in us, man. That's why we have the spirit to do the work of Yahawah Shimmy and Shai. Continually, man. Lord willing, man. Right? He keep us, you know, motivate and keep us walking in the true way of Yahawah Shimmy and Shai. Let me get 2 Timothy. Second Timothy chapter 4. I'm going to start at verse 1. I charge thee, therefore, Yahawah, and the Lord Amashiach Yahushai, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom, preach the word, be instant in season, out of season, rebuke, exalt with all long suffering and doctrine, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine is the truth. The time's gonna come where a lot of people are gonna stop watching videos. Not gonna watch a video them no more, because yo, them not gonna endure sound doctrine no more. Them not gonna want the truth no more. Because what? Them are gonna start having itchy ears, man. Sound doctrine, but after their own lust, they shall heap to themselves teacher having itchy ears. So them are gonna run to the Christian church and feel like them in a good place. And they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned into feeble. But watch thou in all things, endure affliction, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. So that's why, yo, we have to make full proof of what we are doing, man. We can't leg off of this thing, man. We have to hold on to it, because the Heavenly Father gave it unto us, man. Right? Let me get 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 3. Thou, therefore, endure hardness as a good soldier of Yahawashi Amashiach. No man that warring entangle himself with a fear of this life, that he may please him who had chosen him to be a soldier. So, yo, Amashiach Yahawashi chose us to come and take this good fight and fight for him, because he chose us to come to be a soldier, man. So he chose us to come to be a soldier. We can't come give up the fight. We are going to stand up for this fight. Because this fight is pure and true and good, man. Right? Let me get 2 Peter. 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 1. This second apostle, beloved, I now write unto you in both that I stir up your pure mind by way of remembrance. So now we are remember who we are. So the Lord has stirred up our pure mind of remembrance, that you may be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets, and of the commandment of us, the apostle of the Lord and Savior, the Lord, Yahawah bahasham Yahawashi, man, and he must come to save us, man. Right? So he must stir up a pure mind to remembrance. So we know, Sabua, yo, we have to get down and do these works, man, of the Father. Because, yo, I must stir up a pure mind, man. Right? And let me get the book of John chapter 14, and I start at 1, and it read, John chapter 14 verse 1, and it read, let not your heart be troubled, yea, believe in Yahawah, believe also in me. That's Amashiach Yahawashi, tell us to believe in Yahawah, also believe in him, right? Shalom, King, shalom. Yeah, I'm good enough. You know, me shoot a video at this present time, so me call you back as me done here, King. God. Shalom, King. Shalom. God. Yeah, man, that's my loved brother, man. Right, beloved brother, man. Right, and it says, John chapter 14. Verse 2, and it read, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there he may be also. So the Lord has said, I'm going to prepare a place for us, man. So we have to have faith, man, and hold on upon the will of Yahweh Shimei and Shai and his words, man. We have to stand up 10 toes down upon the ground, man, for the Lord, man. Because he's saying, going to prepare a place for us, man. So we have to have faith, man, and hold on and endure and wait, man. Right? He that endure unto the end, man, shall be saved, man. So we have to hold on, man. We have to have faith. Some of us already in the tomb, man. Them still a whole land, man. Cause them spirit are dead. Them spirit still living. And I talk to the Father. Cause them still have communication. Right? Verse 4. And whether I go, ye know. And the way you know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou go. And how can we know the way? Yahawashi said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. So that's why Amashiach, Yahawashi, Amashiach, to him we have to go to the Father, man. Right? And that's why him come here and die for us, man. He died for the sacrificial law. So, yo, through him, we have to go to the Father. And through the Father sent us to him. Right? So that's why the word we, we're just like when I read in John early on. We in him in the Father, you know. And so we have to, you know, carry on, man. Because it's a spirit, man, be a witness with our spirit, man, that we are the children of Yahweh Shimei and Shai. Right? Let me get John 10. Because these are the things that the Lord has said unto us. Now, Mr. John 10, Yeah. John chapter 10, and I start at verse 25. Yeah. Yahusha answered them, I told you, and you believe not. The works that I do in my Father's name, they bear witness of me. So the work of Mashiach Yahusha I do to the blind, to the deaf, to the feeble, to the hungry, right? All works that you have done it in the name of Yahawah. So he done it in the name of Yahawah, and he is the Son. Because the Father put all power in him hand to do the work, man. Right? Verse 26. But you believe not, because you are not of my sheep, as I said unto you. So a lot of people on the ground running up and down, they are not of the Lord's sheep. So that's why the Lord has said, him come for the last sheep of the house of Israel. So if you are not Israelite, you're not going to be the sheep. And you have Israelite who's been wicked. Because why? The enemy come and sow him seed amongst us. So when you look at us, we may look like an Israelite, and basically we are not an Israelite. Because yo, yeah, you might have the same feature, but the spirit in you is not the same as the Israelite man with the faith to serve Yahweh Shimei Shai. It's as simple as that. Because yo, none of us are gonna look alike, but yo, as the Lord said, make the wheat and the thorn, make the wheat and the tear grow together until the day of harvest. And right now the day of harvest is approaching, man. Right? And that's why the Lord said, man, but you believe not, because you are not of my sheep, as I said unto you. My sheep hear my voice, and they knew. My sheep hear my voice, and I knew them, and they follow me, and I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. So you see, nobody can pluck you out of the Lord, man, through the spirit of Yahweh Shimei Shai, man. And I hope you've been edified, and these precepts I'm going to bring out yasharahla. Because yo, yasharahla, you Israelite, man, young hope, when you take off the helmet, and when I say take off the helmet, man, me attack you bulletproof, man, right? And so the Heavenly Father words can, you know, come crushing in onto your good brain, man, and you get understanding, and you can start walk upright with the Yahawah Shimei Shai again, man. Because yo, we there fight the good fight of faith, and I hold firm unto eternal life, man, Lord willing, man, right? And all you brothers out there, man, keep on pushing the works of Yahawah Shimei Shai. Because yo, we all we have on this word is spirit and is life. It's resonated our spirit, man. So we have to keep on continue marching in righteousness, man, through the spirit and power of Yahawah Shimei Shai, man. So let us do it, man. Let us continue to do it, and let us stand up strong for the Heavenly Father, man. Who shall separate us from Yahawah Shimei Shai? Tribulation, famine, hungry, stress, woman, children. Nah, them can't separate us from Mashiach Yahawashi. So we are going to hold on all through the power of Yahawah Shimei Shai. And we say what? Brakita Yahawah, Brakita Yahawashi. Brakita Yahawah, Brakita Yahawashi. And Manuela, Shalom, until the next one. Home Yasharahla.